Hello students, in today's lecture we'll be continuing chapter 1 of NCERT book from class 11, Computer Science. So in the previous lectures we saw about what is a computer, what is a computer system, and what are the main parts of a computer system, right? And in the previous lecture we studied in detail about the CPU and the parts of a CPU, how the CPU actually functions, what are the three main parts of a CPU. Now, in this lecture, we'll be continuing about the main parts of a computer. In the first lecture, we studied about that there are four main parts of a computer that comprise of the CPU, input device, output device, and the secondary storage devices. So we'll be studying about the input devices today. In case you have skipped or missed the previous lectures, I would request you to first go and visit those lectures so that you remain connected with the concepts and your understanding is better for this lecture. All right. So I'll be sharing the links for those videos also throughout the video and at the end also, so you can see those lectures. Now, starting with what are input devices? Input devices are any such device that are connected to the computer and which send control signals or commands to the computer to perform some operation. Okay, these input devices, they basically send some data or information to the computer, or it can be any form of instruction to perform a function. Okay, and these instructions are in the form so that they can be understood by the computer. So when we talk about human understandable language and computer understandable language, there is a contrasting difference between them. So languages like Hindi, English are easily understood by humans, okay? But humans, computers cannot understand those languages. Computer can only understand signals in the form of binary digits, okay, zeros and ones, and these are known as binary numbers or binary digits or even bits. We'll be studying about this in the later videos also. So the input devices basically convert the input data into a form that can be understood by the computer, and that form is the digital form, in the form of zeros and ones, okay? So two important things that you have to remember about input devices are that they send control signals or instructions to the computer, and they convert the input data into a form, into a digital form that can be acceptable or understandable by the computer system. And when you are describing about input devices, what are the main input devices that you see in your daily life that are connected to the computer? It can be your keyboard, it can be your mouse, your scanner, because all these things are used to send input to the computer. Okay, you type using the keyboard, you select or you double click using the mouse, you scan a document or a photograph, or you send information into the computer using a scanner. Similarly, there are touch screens, touch pads, or even for blind students or visually impaired students, there are braille keyboards, right? And also in today's era, there are search engines that allow you to search through your voice. So voice command is also a type of input. Okay, so when describing about different types of input, you can cite these examples. Now, further, you must remember that any input that is given through an input device is stored temporarily into the main memory. Okay, and this main memory is also known as RAM. We'll be studying about this in detail in upcoming lecture. Okay, so in the previous lectures, I told you that CPU basically consists of three main parts. First is the arithmetic logic unit, the second is the control unit, and the third is the primary memory. Now, primary memory can also be divided into two types. The first is the RAM, which we are referring to here, and the second is the ROM. Now, what is RAM and ROM? See, the major difference between these two is that RAM stores data temporarily. It only stores data till the power is supplied to the computer, and as soon as you remove power supply, any data stored in the RAM will be lost. ROM permanently stores data. Okay, so anything that you provide through an input device to the computer system, it goes to the CPU, and in the CPU it gets stored temporarily into the RAM. Okay, this is an important point to remember. Okay, now if you want to store something permanently into the computer, you need to use secondary memory, which are also known as secondary storage devices. Again, we'll be reading about these later in detail. All right, so now summarizing this lecture, whatever we have studied today, if you need to take down the notes or you need to remember the main points, this is the slide that is very important for you. You can prepare your complete notes through this and you can gain marks in your exam also. Okay, so when you have to introduce or when you have to explain about input devices, first you'll be providing the definition. What is an input device? As I told you, it sends any device that sends control signals into the computer, and it converts the input data into a digital form that can be understood by the computer. Okay, then only the computer will be able to perform the task. Now in the second point, you can quote examples of what are input devices. I told you all the examples and they are written here as well. Okay, now the third point is, any input that is transferred to the computer through input device is stored temporarily into main memory. Main memory is also known as random access memory, or which is the full form of RAM. Okay, and last point, in case any input data has to be stored for permanent storage, then it can be stored in the secondary memory. All right, so this was the basic concept of input devices. I hope you do not have any problem in understanding this. In case you have any doubt, you can definitely mention in the comment section below. Let us know which all videos do you want to see further in this playlist, and in the next video we'll be covering about output devices. So till then, mind your exam.